It was Valentine's Day, 2018.
Someone's shooting up the school at Stoneman Douglas.
A day dedicated to spreading love is now one of the most heartbreaking days in Florida's history.
Overwhelming sense of grief.
A former student walked into Stoneman Douglas High School in Parkland, Florida, armed with an AR-15 semi-automatic rifle, killed 17 people, and hurt 17 more.
Sadly, it's our fourth year without Joaquin.
I am trying to be Alyssa's voice.
While we remember the lives lost, a lot has changed to prevent something like this from happening again.
Tonight, we are remembering the 14 students and three faculty members who tragically lost their lives 4 years ago today, and what's been done to prevent it from happening again 4 years later. Thanks for watching ABC 7. I'm Jeff Butera.
Hi, everyone. I'm Krista Fogelsong. The Lee County Sheriff's Office now has a school threat enforcement team dedicated just to tracking threats.
And as of December, Lee County schools received 277 threats from students this school year alone, which is more threats in one semester than in the entirety of the whole last school year.
In your big story tonight at 7, our Amanda Lojeski is getting us more on how the Parkland school shooting changed the way our schools prepare and train for an active shooter.
Lori Al-Hadef lost her daughter, Alyssa, in the massacre. She tells me she's turning her grief into action, and it's one step towards making our schools safer.
I love you. It's going to be fine. Can you hide somewhere? Can you play dead?
That was a mother talking to her child inside Marjorie Stoneman High School in the midst of an active shooter, a feeling that hits home for Lori Al-Hadef.
Today is really hard for me with the death of my daughter, now being 4 years.
Alyssa was shot and killed in her English classroom.
A lot of the children who were shot or witnessed the shootings or were injured were 13, 14-year-olds. And now they're 17 and 18-year-olds.
Abby Finn was on the ground at Parkland as a mental health counselor, helping people cope with the tragedy.
When I got there, they were starting to do the vigil.
For decades, she's been finding ways to prevent school violence.
I studied extensively violence in the workplace and identifying signs of somebody who may potentially be violent at work. And then the school shooting started happening in the late 90s. And it was eerily similar.
She tells me almost all leak their plan to someone else.
And I think that's the place where we've made strides in being able to intervene early on.
We have our fire alarm pull stations, our AEDs. Now every school should have their panic button. And in case there's a life-threatening emergency, we know that help will get there as quickly as possible.
Lori turned her grief into action. She and her husband worked to get Alyssa's law passed. It requires a panic button in every classroom.
I know Alyssa's looking down and she's so happy that we're working hard in her honor to make schools safer and to keep her memory and her legacy alive.
Having talked to survivors, I can honestly tell you, I firmly believe that the training that the students and the faculty go through does save lives.
Alyssa's mom, Lori, says they've introduced a federal law called the Safer Schools Act in hopes of making schools safer across the country. Live in the studio, Amanda Lojeski, ABC 7.
Let's dig deep.